गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2 पार्ट 4th, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन नेफ्रोलिपिस। इट रिप्रोड्यूसेस बाय वेजिटेटिव, असेक्सुअल एंड सेक्सुअल मेथड्स। सो फर्स्ट वी सी द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, दैट इज द वेजिटेटिव रिप्रोडक्शन। ओके, it takes place by death and decay process of rhizome. When the progressive death and decay of the older part of rhizome reaches up to the place of branching, it separates into two branches and continues to grow as a separate individuals. It also takes by budding from primary and secondary stolon of Nephrolepis and finally gives rise to new plants. Okay, then the second type of reproduction, that is the sexual reproduction. The fern plant is a sporophytic plant body. It reproduces asexually by means of formation of spores. At maturity, some of the leaflets or pinna produces reproductive bodies in the form of sori on ventral surface of the leaflet. Such a leaf producing leaflets with sori or fertile pinnae is known as a sporophylls. The sori are a group of asexual reproductive bodies which develop in two rows on the ventral surface of the pinnae along the margins. They develop on one of the fin ending of the forked fins, which is towards the apex. They are light green to brown in color. Each sori consists of a group of sporangia, which develops on cushion like outgrowth of the parenchymatous cells called placenta and covered by a membrane structure called indusium. The indusium is kidney shaped in surface view. The sporangia develop all around the placenta except at the notch. Sporangia produce large number of spores. The placenta provides food material to the developing sporangia and indusium covers and protects the sporangia. Then structure of sporangium. The sporangia are asexual reproductive structure. Each sporangium consists of basal stalk and a distal capsule. The stalk is multicellular, long, slender and made up of 2 to 3 vertical thick walled rows of cells. The capsule is oval by convex and disc like structure. The wall of the capsule is made up of single layer of flat thin walled cells. Along the periphery it shows a distinct incomplete ring of cells which is vertically placed, known as annulus. The cells of the annulus are thick and brown. Along the inner tangential and radial walls, while the outer wall is slightly thin. On one side of the capsule, the annulus is placed by large size, thin-walled, transversely arranged elongated cells. Okay. At maturity, sporangium opens through the cells forming the sporangium. When young, the sporangium contains 16th diploid spore mother cells. At maturity, each spore mother cell undergoes reduction division, that is a meiosis, forming tetrad or 4 haploid spores. Therefore, each sporangium contains 64 spores. Okay, the next point, that is mechanism of dispersal of sporangium. When the sporangium is mature and the weather is dry, the dissemination of spores takes place. The annulus and the Ectomium plays a very important role in the dehiscence of the sporangium. At maturity, the wall of the sporangium starts to lose moisture and dries up. At the same time, cells of the annulus lose water. As a result, the drying of the annulus creates an equal tension on the cell walls. This tension makes the annulus cells strengthen up, and this results into breaking of the sporangium by rupturing the thin-walled cells of stomium. Thus, the sporangium are dispersed. Each spore is more or less kidney-shaped, slightly flattened, dark brown in color. Spore is haploid uninucleate with protoplast. It is made up of two layers, in which the outer layer is thick brown, known as exosporium, and the inner layer is thin walled, known as endosporium. All spores of the same type, therefore, Nephrolepis is homosporous type. Then, next point, that is germination of spores. During favorable condition, the spores germinate, the exospore sporium breaks, and the endosporium grows into a short germ tube. After some time, they divide into two unequal cells, that is rhizoidal cells and prothallial cells. The rhizoidal cells is small and colorless, which gives rise to unicellular rhizoids. The latter, by repeated transfer cell division, gives rise to green filamentous structure. Soon the division takes place in the plane to form green plate like body. Due to more rapid division and growth of the marginal cells, the plate like structure gets converted into more or less heart shaped structure called as prothallus. Okay, then we must know that is gametophyte. Prothallus is the gametophyte of fern. It is haploid, dorsiventrally flattened, green, delicate and heart shaped structure, measuring about 5 mm across. At the broader end it shows notch, while vertically at the narrow posterior end it produces unicellular hair like structures called rhizoids. Their main function is absorption of water and minerals from the soil and fixation of gametophyte. The prothallus is one cell thick, except towards the notch. Here it is many layered forms, forming a cushion like structure. The cells of the prothallus is closely arranged, thin walled and full of chloroplast. They are autotrophic in nature. Prothallus is monoecious. At maturity it produces both male and female sex organs, that is Antheridia and Archegonia. Then after that we must see structure of the sex organs. First we see that is the Antheridia. The Antheridia are male sex organs which are developed vertically towards the narrow posterior end in between the rhizoids. Each antheridium is sessile, has a globose structure. The wall of the antheridium is made up of three cells. The proximal shallow first ring cell, the middle second ring cell, and the apical third cap cell. The body of antheridium is filled with anthrozoids, mother cells or androcytes, each of which metamorphoses into a single male gametes called as anthrozoids or spermatozoids. Each anthrozoid is haploid. It is a multiflagellate coiled structure. Under humid conditions, the antheridium absorbs water. The mucilaginous content swells up, and as a result, the lead cell comes off. The anthrozoids coated with mucilage are liberated. Mucilage dissolves in water and the anthrozoids are free to swim in the film of water. Archegonia. The archegonia are the female sex organs which develop vertically on the anterior cushion like area towards the notch of the prothallus. Each archegonium is a sessile inverted flask shaped structure that consists of a globose venter and a tubular neck. The venter is completely embedded in the prothallial cells. It contains a single large egg or oospore towards the base and venter canal cells towards the neck. The neck is short and curved towards posterior end. The wall of the neck is single layered in thickness with cells arranged in four longitudinal rows and closed at the tip by lead cells. It consists of single elongated binucleated neck canal cells. Okay, thank you.